My name is Terry W. I'm from Rochester, New York. I grew up in a blue-collar, hardcore, vodka-drinking, potato-eating family. And alcoholism and violence was so prevalent, it was something that I thought was the normal thing for all families, you know? And when I grew up, I wanted to be just like my grandpa, who was past an alcoholic. You know, alcoholism was rampant in my family. I always felt as though I had to be something more than I was to my family, something more than I, it was never enough. I first really had my first drink when I was 13, and I no longer needed to jump off roofs for excitement. You know, when I first got introduced to alcohol, I said, wow, where have you been all my life? I felt as though I arrived. By the time I was 13, I started drinking. By the time I was 15, I started doing drugs. And by the time I was 18, I was drinking every day. It was never enough, you know, for me. And I began to start having consequences in high school and into college. One thing that really progressed my drinking career was in high school, I fractured my neck. First dose of opiates at that time, you know, and thought that was fun. Enjoyed that. Enjoyed the attention that I got. After I got out of the hospital, all the glitz and glamour was gone, and I lost football, something that was the most important thing to me. And I lost a scholarship. I had a scholarship to play football at Cornell, and I was told I could no longer play football. And that's when I became really angry and really violent, and I began to drink every day. I drank pretty much through my senior year, got into college, somehow got myself through college. I had a lot of consequences all through college, lots of consequences, and people began to not want to be around me. You know, my sphere of people began to shrink after college. Wasn't working, had the money in the bank from a injury related to alcohol. And so as my sphere began to get smaller and smaller, and people wanted, and parents and family members, the people who were hardcore alcoholic drinkers said, I think you have a problem. I had no idea, you know, a problem, and, you know, I can control it. It came back to I can take care of this and I can control it. And I was self-will run riot, to be honest, and thought I could fix this. And eventually got to the point where I needed to really do something about my drinking, and I thought getting married would be the answer. And so I went to church. And found a woman who I'm an unbelievable person, and I'm blessed to have that same person in my life today. When I drank, there was problems. There was consequences, you know, and as my drinking career progressed and my children began to get older, I began to drink alone. You know, I didn't want to be around people. People didn't want to be around me. Well, the other thing that happened to me, an important part of what happened for me to arrive here, is my brother introduced my wife to Al-Anon. So I came home one day, and my wife had changed the locks, and all my stuff was out on the front yard, and I said, perfect, now I could drink. That wasn't enough for me to stop at that point. That was a reason for me to drink more. I began the beginning stages of cirrhosis of the liver. Ambulance visits, still wasn't enough. Drinking in my basement, really physically addicted to alcohol. I was at a point in my life where I felt like if I had another drink, I was gonna die. And if I didn't have a drink, it was gonna kill me. I went into DTs, I went into seizures. Tried to still do it on my own, tried to do it alone. And I was in intensive care for 7 days. My wife, whom I was separated with at the time, had come to the hospital and said, I called Tully Hill and there's a bed open. It just opened up. you're getting out tomorrow. There's one bed open. And she says, it's up to you. I wish you luck. The seat is there. If you want to go, I'll take you. And my daughter, who was 11 years old at the time, said, Daddy, I heard you're not going away. I don't want you to die like Unky. And she said, please go. Please go away to this special place that mommy found. I want my dad back. So I called my wife up and I said, pack a bag. And I came to Tully Hill and I learned about the we here. And I learned in these four walls of Tully Hill that there's strength in numbers. There's power in numbers. There was safety in numbers. And it turned out for an alcoholic like me, there was life in numbers. I'm ever so grateful for what Tully Hill has done for me. Today, life is wonderful.